Come in.
Eric?
Pretty pleased with yourself there, huh?
Yeah.
Do you realize after what you and Edge did last week on Raw, my phone's been ringing off the hook?
I can only imagine.
Do you know how much risk you put every fan in the arena in? Do you realize you put this company at risk? Do you realize you put me at risk? I could have been sued.
That's not my problem, Eric.
Oh, really?
The only thing I'm worried about is getting my hands and hurting Edge.
Well, it's my problem. But I think I've got a solution to both of our problems right here in this contract. Since you two can't stand the ground each other walks on, and since I can't trust you in an arena around the fans, you sign that contract, you've got your rematch with Edge at Unforgiven inside of a steel cage.
Steel cage, huh, Eric? I'll tell you, I definitely like the sound of that. And it's only going to take me a minute to make that decision.
Glad to hear it.
So there's your contract. And Unforgiven, I'm going to finish what I've started with Edge. And regardless of what he does to me, or what I do to him, Edge will realize that Matt Hardy will not die.
Oh, not so fast. Will not die, huh?
Right.
I think we're going to put that theory to the test tonight. See, I know that you and Edge are in no shape to compete tonight, but since it's a condition of this contract and, well, you've heard the old saying, the show must go on.
Sure.
I want to see you in a tune-up match tonight. Matt Hardy versus Snitsky next.
Oh, man. No.
What's next?
That's not right.
And now, the WWE Body Slam of the Week is brought to you by Bod Fragrance Body Sprays for Men. Also, try new Bod Fragrance Deodorant Sprays.
Oh, double choke slam and a double pin. Hey, Snitsky trying to get a piece of the Big Show. Good God,
Snitsky has just knocked our time.
For Matt Hardy as he makes his way in his street clothes down to the ring. This match, a colored tune-up match by our general manager. There's no doubt that Matt Hardy, no matter how hard he's trying, is in no condition to compete here tonight.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from Cameron, North Carolina, weighing in at 236 pounds, Matt Hardy.
Well, Matt Hardy's getting a standing ovation, but you can tell by the way he's walking. He can barely stand. Look at,
Well, there's no doubt Matt Hardy is certainly gutting it out tonight like he always does each and every week. But as Eric Bischoff said, the show boys must go off.
Matt Hardy's just putting his gear on now. I guess this is an alternative that to signing that steel cage match, and this is not going to go.
This is not good. That's
from Mahoning, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 300 pounds.
Well, Snitsky is dressed to compete. We saw Snitsky, as he came back on the air moments ago, knocking out the Big Show last week with not one, but two shots to the head with a ring bell.
Well, he rang his bell, so to speak, wouldn't you say, JR?
Well, it just goes to show that Snitsky will do absolutely anything to any... Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Edge and Lita.
Now, Matt Hardy, no condition to compete, and neither is Edge.
Yeah, no doubt about that.
Well, it looks like they're coming over here, but Matt, you better not take your eyes off of Snitsky.
Well, apparently, they want to get another round.
Whoa.
It's become like a permanent seat for Lita and Edge.
Well, I like Lita's seat. Have a seat.
Well, exactly the meaning of this, but this match, it's got me very concerned. This match in the ring with Matt Hardy in the condition that he is in. We're going to try to gut it out here with Snitsky and Matt in absolutely no condition to compete here tonight, as is our guest Edge in no condition to compete.
You're damn right I'm in no condition to compete. Neither
but
is Matt.
A lot better because my excellent nurse duties that I performed this.
Oh, no doubt you know what you're doing.
that did make this week a little bit easier, but I will give Matt Hardy credit.
What a clothesline!
He tried to take me down last week, and he almost, and I stress almost, got the job done.
Well,
but
baby,
I'm still here, and
you,
I'm still breathing.
You still got the job done, even in that neck collar.
Oh, man.
You know, off the record.
I do what I do.
Oh, keep it on the record. Tell us more. How badly is Matt Hardy's body aching right now after that street fight last week?
What about mine? If he feels anything like me, I know he shouldn't be in there after what I did to him. I feel like hell.
Oh, a clean shot right to the head of Matt Hardy by the psycho Snitsky.
What a guy to put old Hardy in with tonight. Snitsky might finish the job that I've been starting.
But it wouldn't be his fault, though.
No, of course not.
Well, what about Unforgiven inside the steel cage? We just heard about that. What are your thoughts about that, Edge? Are you looking forward to that Unforgiven match in the cage?
Yeah, I am. Because you know what? Matt Hardy, you know what I equal for Matt Hardy? I equal career suicide. I will end his career. He's barking up the wrong tree, JR,
but
he hasn't realized it yet, and he should.
Well, will Lita be able to nurse you back to 100% here?
That's the damn movie game last week.
Yeah, brings back some memories.
A gutsy move by Matt Hardy trying to fight his way back into this thing.
My question is how are either one of these men, Matt Hardy or Edge himself, going to be ready to 13
it took
days?
More out of It took more out of Hardy than it did Snitsky. What is he thinking? Where do you think you're coming? What the hell is he doing? Is he coming up?
Snitsky from behind.
Matt Hardy
I
gotta
believe it.
If he came up here, I would have beat his ass again just like I did last week.
You know, you're listening to him.
Oh, that's a shame. How you doing, Matthew?
Getting what they're asking for.
How are you, Matthew?
This match is certainly unfair for Matt Hardy. A tune-up match. When is your tune-up match, Edge?
I wish I had a tune-up match. I asked for one.
Well,
you don't think?
Edge, no. Oh, man, that's the kind of competitor you are.
Almighty. Count.
Oh, no.
That's a shame.
Snitsky, son.
So much for his tune-up match.
You can't be proud of. Wait a minute.
I'm proud of Snitsky.
That's it,
Gene. I'm proud of him right now.
Put that bell down.
I'm proud of Gene Snitsky.
We saw what you did with that last week.
Yeah, that's a stand-up man right there. Do it, Gene.
Now this could finish Matt Hardy off for good.
Gene, don't do it. Don't do it. Please don't hit him with that bell. Whatever you do, Gene.
Oh, this is sick. Matt Hardy can't even defend himself.
Oh, no. Poor Matt.
Snitsky does this. There's no way
Bless
Matt
his
Hardy
little heart.
Gets the heart.
Do it, Gene.
Snitsky knocked out last week, the 500-pound Big Show.
Do it, Snitsky.
No, do it, Snitsky.
Do it.
Hurry up, Snitsky.
Come on,
do it.
Do it. Knock his head off.
Don't do it, Snitsky.
That's it.
Snitsky running like a scalded dog on the Big Show. But the damage has been done to Matt Hardy. Snitsky didn't want a piece of the Big Show. That was obvious. It was also obvious that Matt Hardy had no business being in this tune-up match.
Well, you can thank Eric Bischoff for that.
Well, JR, I think Matt Hardy had his bell wrong.
Just a little bit. Just a little bit.
Just a sample. I'll
take you back to earlier tonight and show you what Tyson Tonto did to the WWE champion. Kurt Angle defeated Eugene. Angle didn't want to release the ankle lock. Had a grapevine there. Was going to break Eugene's ankle, no doubt about it. Here comes John Cena. Cena gets a better at Kurt Angle. But then the boom is lowered on the champ.
Well, you got that right. Here comes from behind into your screen.
Bam!
Tonto with a big boot right to the head of John Cena.
Well, you're talking about guts. John Cena may have more guts than Reigns. Because later on tonight, John Cena will compete with the concussion. And it's going to be next against Tyson Tonto.
Coach.
I just thanked him.